Dear students, in this class, we will discuss the rotational vibrational spectrum of diatomic molecules and also the influence of rotation on the vibrational spectra of polyatomic molecules. Pure vibrational spectra are observed only in liquids, where interaction between molecules inhibit rotation. Since rotational energy is smaller than vibrational energy, in the gaseous state, along with vibration, rotations are also observed. We know that according to Born-Oppenheimer approximation, rotations and vibrations are independent of each other. So excluding electronic energy, we can write the total energy epsilon total equals epsilon rotational plus epsilon vibrational, that is rotational energy plus vibrational energy, and this is in centimeter inverse. That is epsilon jv equals epsilon j plus epsilon v, which is equal to bj into j plus 1, the rotational term, plus v plus half into nu e bar minus v plus half the whole square nu e bar xe. This is the vibrational term, where xe is the enharmonicity constant and nu e bar is the equilibrium vibrational frequency. So the selection rules for combined vibrational and rotational transitions are delta V equals plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, etc. and delta J equals plus or minus 1. In the case of a diatomic molecule, it may not have delta J equals 0. And that means a vibrational change will always be accompanied by a simultaneous rotational change. Only under very special circumstances, delta J equals 0 is allowed, whereas in most of the cases, delta J will be equal to plus or minus 1. Considering only the V equals 0 to V equal to 1 transition, which is the fundamental transition, it will be the most intense. So, delta epsilon JV equals epsilon J dash V equal to 1 minus epsilon J double dash V equal to 0. The J dash represents the upper state and J double dash represents the lower state. Okay. So that will be equal to nu 0 bar plus B into J dash minus J double dash into J dash plus J double dash plus 1 centimeter inverse, where nu 0 bar equals nu E bar into 1 minus 2XE. The frequency nu 0 bar is called the band center or band origin. If delta J equal to plus 1, we have J dash minus J double dash equals 1. That means J dash equals J double dash plus 1. Then we can write this equation as delta epsilon equals nu 0 bar plus 2B into J double dash plus 1 centimeter inverse, where J double dash equals 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Similarly, if delta J equal to minus 1, then J dash minus J double dash will be equal to minus 1, or J double dash equals J dash plus 1. Therefore, delta epsilon can be written as nu 0 bar minus 2B J dash plus 1 centimeter inverse, where J dash equals 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So combining these two, we can write delta epsilon JV equals nu 0 bar plus 2BM centimeter inverse, where M equals either J dash plus 1 or J double dash plus 1, and its value will be plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, etc. Now the value of M is positive if delta J equal to plus 1, and it is negative if delta J equals minus 1. And M cannot be 0, since that would imply J dash or J double dash to be minus 1. And as I said earlier, the frequency nu 0 bar, which is equal to nu e bar into 1 minus 2xe. And this is called the band center or band origin. And the spectrum, that is the rotational vibrational spectrum of a diatomic molecule, will consist of equally spaced lines with a spacing 2b on each side of the band center or band origin. So this is the vibrational rotational spectrum of a diatomic molecule like HCl. You can see a series of lines on the low frequency and high frequency side. The separation between these lines will be 2B. Delta G equal to minus 1 represents the lines to the low frequency side of nu 0 bar, represented as blue lines here, and that is referred to as the P branch. And if delta G equal to plus 1, and that represents lines to the higher frequency side of the nu 0 bar, and that is represented as green lines here, and it is called R branch. So in the vibrational rotational spectrum of a diatomic molecule, you will have a series of P branch and R branch lines on either side of the band center. And in this spectrum, since M is not equal to 0, the line at nu 0 bar will not appear in this spectrum. Now let's discuss the rotational vibrational spectra of polyatomic molecules. We have seen that the rotational vibrational spectra of diatomic molecules give rise to equally spaced lines for P and R branches in the first approximation. And for the vibrations to be IR active, we know that the selection rule is there must be a change of dipole moment during the vibration. For complex molecules or polyatomic molecules, the vibrations can be divided into two categories. Vibrations causing a dipole change, either parallel to the major axis of rotational symmetry or perpendicular to the major axis of rotational symmetry. And these are called parallel and perpendicular vibrations respectively. So first consider the spectra of linear molecules. We will directly go to the selection rules. For parallel vibrations, the selection rules are delta J equals plus or minus 1, delta V equals plus or minus 1 for simple harmonic motion. And if you are considering anharmonic motion, then delta J equals plus or minus 1. And delta V will be plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, etc. So here, the spectra will be similar to that of a diatomic molecule consisting of P and R branches equally spaced on each side. But the moment of inertia will be larger and smaller B value. Hence, the P or R branch line spacing will be less in the case of linear polyatomic molecules. That is, the spacing between lines is likely to be less as the moment of inertia is expected to be large. And when the moment of inertia is extremely large, then the individual lines of the branches will merge, resulting in two lines. So this is about the parallel vibrations. So parallel vibrations of linear molecules will be the same as that of a spectra of the diatomic molecules. Now next we'll consider the perpendicular vibrations of linear molecules. For perpendicular vibrations, the selection rules will be delta V equals plus or minus 1 and delta J equals 0 plus or minus 1. So here delta J equals 0 and plus or minus 1. That means a vibrational change can take place with no simultaneous rotational transition. So this is the rotational vibrational spectrum corresponding to perpendicular vibrations of a linear molecule. On the low frequency side, we can see the P branch, and on the high frequency side, we can see the R branch. And here, since delta J equals 0, we can see the lines corresponding to, or the transitions corresponding to delta J equal to 0, and that is represented as the Q branch. So we'll have a three sets of lines, P branch, Q branch, and R branch. So transitions with delta J equal to 0 corresponds to the Q branch. And the Q branch consists of lines superimposed upon each other at the band center, and it is usually very intense. So in the case of linear molecules, for parallel vibrations, the spectra will be the same as that of diatomic molecule. And for perpendicular vibrations, we have an additional selection rule, that is delta J equal to 0 and plus or minus 1. And the transitions with delta J equal to 0 corresponds to Q branch lines, so that the vibration rotational spectrum will consist of P branch lines, Q branch lines, and also R branch lines. Next, we will see the spectra of symmetric top molecules. The vibrational rotational energy levels of a symmetric top is given by epsilon jv equals v plus half nu e bar minus v plus half the whole square x e nu e bar plus bj into j plus 1 plus a minus b into k square centimeter inverse, where a equals h by 8 pi square I a into c and b equals h by 8 pi square I b into c. Both are rotational constants corresponding to two different moment of inertia I a and I b. For symmetric top also we'll have parallel and perpendicular vibrations. So let's see the selection rules. For parallel vibrations, we have delta V equals plus or minus 1, delta J equals 0 plus or minus 1, and we have an additional quantum number, that is delta K equals 0. And for perpendicular vibrations, we have delta V equals plus or minus 1, delta J equals 0 plus or minus 1, and delta K equals plus or minus 1. In the case of parallel vibrations, we have seen that delta K equals 0. That means the spectrum is independent of this K. In other words, the spectrum will have features similar to those observed for perpendicular vibrations of linear molecules. Now consider the perpendicular vibrations of the symmetric top. The selection rules will lead to the following frequencies for the three branches. For R branch, we have delta J equal to plus 1 and delta K equals plus or minus 1. So nu R will be equal to nu 0 bar plus 2B J plus 1 plus A minus B into 1 plus or minus 2K centimeter inverse. Now for P branch, delta J equal to minus 1, delta K equals plus or minus 1. So we have nu P bar equals nu 0 bar minus 2B into J plus 1 plus A minus B into 1 plus or minus 2K centimeter inverse. And we also have a Q branch corresponding to delta J equal to 0 and delta K equals plus or minus 1. And we'll get nu Q bar equals nu 0 bar plus A minus B into 1 plus or minus 2K centimeter inverse. Since delta J equal to 0, there will not be this term 2B into J plus 1 here. So nu 0 bar plus A minus B 1 plus or minus 2k centimeter inverse. So these corresponds to three different branches, P, Q and R branches in the spectra of symmetric top molecules corresponding to perpendicular vibrations. Now, since for each j value, k has the allowed values minus j, minus j plus 1, etc. up to j minus 1, j. So this type of vibration gives rise to many sets of P and R branch lines. The Q branch also consists of a series of lines on both sides of the band center, nu 0 bar, separated by 2 into A minus B. That is, the line spacing will be 2 into A minus B instead of 2B in the case of linear molecules. Also, the lines show a periodical variation of intensity, like strong, weak, weak, strong, weak, weak, etc. And this is because of the threefold rotation axis of symmetry. And also, the nuclear spin changes the relative population of the rotational levels. We have seen that when the molecule has a twofold axis of symmetry, the periodicity will vary according to strong, weak, etc. That is twofold periodicity. So similarly, if the molecule has a threefold axis of symmetry, the intensity of the lines will vary threefold. That is strong, weak, weak, etc. And this type of variation of intensity of lines can be seen in the spectra of symmetric top molecules like CH3I, CH3Cl, etc. So from looking at the intensity of the lines, a variation of intensity of lines, we can confirm whether the molecule belongs to a linear molecule or a symmetrical top. So in this class, we have discussed rotational vibrational spectra of a diatomic, linear polyatomic and also symmetric top molecules. And as the complexity of the molecule increases, the rotational vibrational spectrum will also be much complicated. and hence we'll not be discussing the vibrational spectra of asymmetric top molecules.